Good morning students, in this session we will study the topic stress concentration. Now before studying the stress concentration, we will split up the word stress concentration in two parts. Concentration, it is defined as the concentration of stress in a member at any point caused due to non-homogeneity or abrupt change in dimensions, or it is also defined as the stress value whose value is greater than the stress calculated by normal strength equations. Hence, stress concentration is defined as the concentration of high stress due to discontinuities or abrupt changes of cross section. Or stress concentration is defined as stress whose value is greater than the stress calculated by normal strength equations, or it is defined as the stress at a point generally greater than the stress level determined by the elementary strength equations. Now, while determining the strength of equation of a member, there are certain assumptions. That assumptions are: material is homogeneous, the material is smooth, having smooth surface, it is flawless and uniform in cross section. But in actual practice it is not so. While determining the strength of equation, we have these assumptions. On these assumptions we have the strength of equations, like sigma t is equal to p upon a in tension, sigma c is equal to p upon a in compressions, tau is equal to p upon a in direct shear, and e upon r m upon I is equal to sigma b upon y in bending, and t upon j equal to c theta upon l equal to tau upon d by 2 in torsion. These are the strength equation based on these assumptions. We cannot insist or force the designer to keep the section of uniform cross section. Take the case of shaft. The key way is to be cut to mount the another machine member like sprocket, gears and pulley. So whenever we mount another machine element, that is gear or sprocket, to prevent the relative motion, the key way is to be cut on the shaft. This is the shaft, and key way is provided by mounting another machine part. We insert the key. The key prevents the relative motion between the machine part and shaft. So it is essential to provide key way on the shaft. Now take the example of shaft. This is the shaft of uniform cross section. We cannot keep the shaft of uniform cross section. Suppose we want to mount the bearing for sake of support. In that case, to avoid the axial movement, collar is necessary or undercut is necessary to mount the bearing on the shaft. Now take the example of fastener. Fasteners functionally require a head at one end and thread at other end. This is a fastener. This requires head at one end and threads at other end. So you cannot force the designer to keep the dimensions uniform throughout the section. Now secondly, inherent characteristic caused by the manufacturing process, or inherent defects caused by the manufacturing process. Take the case of casting. In case of casting, non-homogeneity of material, presence of impurities, blowholes, air holes, mismatching, surface roughness, these are the inherent defects caused during the casting process. Second manufacturing process, that is in forging. Forging cracks, mismatching is the defect distortion presence in hot forging process. These are the defects of the forging process. Forging cracks are there, mismatching is there, distortion is there. In welding process, the defects are warping, distortion, bending due to uneven heating and cooling of the workpiece. So, any type of discontinuity causes non-uniform stress distribution in the member, and these points are known as stress risers. Now, the stress concentration factor is defined as the maximum stresses at discontinuity to the normal stresses and in the member, and it is denoted by KT. Consider this section, rectangular section of uniform cross section. In this case, the stress distribution is uniform and given by sigma O is given by P upon A, where A is the cross sectional area of the uniform cross section, that is B into A. The normal stress distribution, the value of that normal stresses is given by sigma O is equal to P upon A. While in non-uniform cross section, suppose we drill a hole, in that case this section become non-uniform. In that case, the stress distribution will be non-uniform. Here, the stresses will be maximum and this is comes to the minimum. So, stress concentration will be there. So, the stress concentration factor is defined as the maximum stresses at discontinuity. These are the maximum stresses at discontinuity to the normal stresses in the member. So this is all about the stress concentration factor. So in this session we have studied what is stress concentration. It is the concentration of the stresses due to abrupt change in dimensions or non-homogeneity or defects due to manufacturing process. And these are the causes of the stress concentrations. And stress concentration factor, which is ratio of the maximum stresses at discontinuity to the nominal stresses of the member, and it is indicated by the letter KT. This is also known as theoretical stress concentration factor or geometrical stress concentration factor, because it depends upon the geometry of the member. So here we end the session. We will meet in the next session. Thank you very much.